Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to identification of group 7 halides in precipitation reactions, decomposition, bond energy, bond length, and other properties of hydrogen halides. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question 12. A white powder of mixture of sodium chloride and sodium iodide. It is dissolved in water in a test tube. An excess of aqueous silver nitrate is added to the test tube. A precipitate X is observed. An excess of concentrated ammonia is then added to the test tube containing X. After the test tube has been shaken, a precipitate Y is observed. Which statement about X or Y is correct? Now, let's write the chemical equation for this. We have silver nitrate added to the test tube of sodium chloride and sodium iodide. So the product precipitate could be silver chloride solid or silver iodide. Silver chloride precipitate is white in color, while silver iodide is yellow. When concentrated ammonia is added to both of them, what happens that in the presence of concentrated ammonia, HCl dissolves, while in the presence of concentrated ammonia, silver iodide is insoluble. It means that the resulting color should be yellow. Now, A says X is pure white in color. No, X should be silvery white because X is silver chloride. So this is wrong. X is silver iodide. No, it is silver chloride. Y is pure silver chloride. No, Y is silver iodide. Y is yellow. So the only option that is correct is D. Question 18. A test tube of HBr and a separate test tube of HI are heated to the same temperature. Which combination of observations is possible? Now we know that in hydrogen halides, HF is the strongest bond and HI is the weakest bond. This is because of the electronegativity difference. The bond strength decreases. As the bond strength decreases, so it is easy to decompose HI as compared to HBr. When HI is decomposed, it converts into hydrogen and iodine. The color of iodine is purple. Therefore, the only option that is correct is D. Question 36. The bond of the HBr molecule is dashed than that of the HI molecule. Which pairs of words correctly complete the above sentences? Let's compare the bond of HBr with HI. We know that bromine is more electronegative, so therefore HBr bond is more strong as compared to HI. Now when electronegative element is present, actually the bond length decreases, so therefore the bond length of HBr is less than HI. Third is bond polarity. As we know that bromine molecule is more electronegative as compared to iodine, so therefore HBr will be more polar than HI. One says that HBr has greater energy as compared to HI, so this is correct. Two says HBr has less bond length as compared to HI, this is also correct. Three says HBr has greater polarity as compared to HI, this is also correct. So all three options are correct, therefore answer is A. Question 16. Concentrated sulfuric acid is added to separate solid samples of sodium chloride, sodium bromide, and sodium iodide.
With which samples does sulfuric acid act as an oxidizing agent? Now, three salts are given. One is sodium chloride, second is sodium bromide, and third is sodium iodide. All of these react with sulfuric acid concentrated to form product, which is sulfate. Sodium chloride forms sodium hydrogen sulfate with concentrated sulfuric acid. Sodium bromide also forms sodium hydrogen sulfate. Sodium iodide also forms sodium hydrogen sulfate. The second product in case of NaCl and concentrated sulfuric acid is HCl. In NaBr, the second product formed is HBr. In sodium iodide reaction, the second product formed is HI. So far, no change in oxidation state have occurred. For example, sodium was plus 1, it is still plus 1. Cl was negative 1, it is still negative 1. Similarly, sulfur in H2SO4 was plus 6, it is still plus 6. So, sulfuric acid has not yet acted as oxidizing agent. Upon further reaction, we can see that HCl is not oxidized by concentrated sulfuric acid because there is no reaction. As sulfuric acid is unable to oxidize HCl. While HBr can be oxidized by concentrated sulfuric acid into products, the reaction will be HBr plus sulfuric acid. It will form bromine, sulfur dioxide, and water. The oxidation state of bromide in reactant was negative 1, while in bromine it is 0. So from negative 1 to 0 it is called oxidation. While sulfuric acid, sulfur was plus 6, which is converted into SO2, in which oxidation state is plus 4. So this is reduction. So it means that upon reaction with sodium bromide, concentrated sulfuric acid does behave as an oxidizing agent. The third reaction is with iodide, and iodide can also be oxidized by concentrated sulfuric acid. The reaction will be like this. As in the reaction, we can see that iodide has changed from negative 1 to 0, so again it is oxidation. And sulfuric acid has shifted from plus 6 to plus 4, which is reduction. So we can say that upon reaction with sodium iodide, concentrated sulfuric acid does behave as oxidizing agent. A. Sodium chloride only. This is wrong. B. Sodium chloride and bromide. This is incorrect. C. Sodium bromide and sodium iodide. So C is the correct answer. Question 38. Organic compound X gives a precipitate when warmed with aqueous silver nitrate. This precipitate dissolves when concentrated aqueous ammonia is added. What could X be? In 1, we have 1 bromopropane, so the halogen is bromo. In 2, we have chloro. In 3, we have iodo. Now we know that with silver nitrate, what will happen? That first one will form AgBr precipitate. Second one will form AgCl as a precipitate. Third one will form AgI as a precipitate. Among these three precipitates, first two dissolve in concentrated aqueous ammonia, while third one does not dissolve. So option 1 and 2 are correct. The answer is therefore B. Question 17. When concentrated sulfuric acid is added to solid sodium bromide, bromine gas is produced along with a number of other products. However, when concentrated sulfuric acid is added to solid sodium chloride, only hydrogen chloride and sodium hydrogen sulfate are produced. What is the reason for this difference? We can write the equation. Concentrated sulfuric acid is H2SO4. It reacts with sodium bromide. NaBr, the oxidation state of Br is minus 1 to form bromine gas. So the oxidation state is 0 along with the number of other products. However, in second reaction, we have concentrated sulfuric acid that reacts with sodium chloride. Oxidation state of chlorine is negative 1. The product formed is HCl and sodium hydrogen sulfate. NaHSO4 along with HCl. Now in HCl, we can see that the oxidation state of chlorine has not changed. So it means that sulfuric acid can oxidize bromide to bromine, but it cannot oxidize chloride to chlorine. Let's move towards the options. In A, we have bromine is less volatile than chlorine. Now this statement is true, but it has nothing to do with this chemical reaction, as in this reaction, oxidation and reduction is involved. B, hydrochloric acid is a weak acid. This is a wrong statement and it has nothing to do with this chemical reaction. C, sulfuric acid is not an oxidizing agent. This is also incorrect because we can see that sulfuric acid is making bromide go into bromine. So oxidation of bromide takes place. So therefore, sulfuric acid is acting as an oxidizing agent. Part D, the bromide ion is a stronger reducing agent than the chloride ion. Now this is a true statement because chloride ion is not a stronger reducing agent as compared to bromide, because bromide is being oxidized to bromine while chloride does not oxidize to chlorine. Its oxidation state is still the same in the product. So therefore, bromide ion is a stronger reducing agent than chloride ion. The answer is therefore D. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.